area. So then we have like near like Fran, like the bathroom hallway. Then we have Mr. Andrews hallway. How hard is it to get through, like, you know, those people? It's like you gotta be like a linebacker and you gotta just go in with your shoulder and just like push everybody out. And then that causes conflict because it's, you stepped on my shoes, you pushed me, you dropped my pencil, you pushed my book. How many conflicts start there? So I feel like the hallways, like the traffic in the hallways, like start so many things because we're like feeling like we have to fight each other just to get through it. Instead of like, you know, like if we had actual traffic ways, it'd be like, oh, all one way, whatever. But I just feel like we have to go against each other just to get in like one place, you know? It takes so long. And we don't have that much time, so.
And then I, as the facilitator, saw my group split up and take part in working together with kids that they didn't know, and they talked about these conflicts that we all recognize, that we don't sit back and think, oh man, I'm dreading lunch because I get to see my friends. But when you get there, it's stressful. When you're leaving, it's stressful. And then to then go and sit in there, no one really thinks of lunch as the environment that does create conflict, whether it be when you're coming or when you're going. But if we all think about it, that's where it's most hectic. We do have teachers walking around, teachers patrolling, but at the same time, those teachers, I'm not speaking for all, but for the most part, they're kind of sitting back, just kind of watching. They're on their prep. They have other things that they could be doing as well that they then may not take a part in. Oh, let this kid go. This kid's been waiting to get his lunch. Let this kid go in this hallway. I know this hallway may not go this way, but he really needs to get his books before his class. Let's break up this conflict in the hallway that only was started by the fact that these kids can't go this way in the hallway.
Right.
There's not a lot of people sitting back and worrying about everyone. So our group as a whole discussed how we can not only worry about ourselves, whether it's I need to get my milk, I need to get my water, I need to get my lunch, I need to get to class, this kid needs to get out of my way.
Right.
But it's a matter of everyone kind of sitting back and maybe using a zipper effect. We all know we're kids in high school, we're starting to drive, you get on the highway, you let someone go, you go, the person behind you goes, it works like a zipper. If we come into the lunchroom, we work like a zipper. The kid in front of you goes, you go, a kid off to the left goes, a kid off to the right goes. It'll work better for not only us as students, but us as a school. It'll be more productive. It'll make the lunchroom less hectic. And if we can communicate rather than walking by someone and scoffing because they may be in your way or they may have grabbed the food that you were going to grab, it'll bring us together as people in our school.